Today we're going to be pulling apart two different toys to see which one's better. The Mixie versus the Beastlab.
In one corner we have the Magic Mixie. In the other corner we have the Beastlab.
What magic will you create? I can tell your future. Your magic power is real. Colorama.
Wow!
Save the world from destruction. Experiment to create your beast. Shark. Twist for power strike attack. Scan to find out more.
First up, we've got the Mixie.
Okay, there's a lot to this toy. I'm going to start unwrapping it, I guess.
So satisfying. We got some instructions and a seemingly empty orb. See what we have to do. Jiggle one upwards to summon magical sunshine. And downwards for mystical moonlight. All right, that is releasing the power.
Oh, I've got to press the spell button on here.
I think I did it. It's got all this mist coming out. Form your Mixie's voice. Jiggle upwards to teach Mixie to sing higher and higher. Downwards to go lower. Magicus Mixus. I think something's happening. my friend! So, we've unleashed our Mixie from its crystal ball. And it's quite the talkative little thing. There is a lot going on with this toy. I'm probably not going to go through all of the different game modes here, but it's super cool. This wand somehow speaks to the Mixie. It's got a whole bunch of different modes, so feels like there's a lot of time you can spend playing with this toy, which is really cool because I was originally thinking that it would just be the reveal, and then that would be it and she would just be like a plush toy. But there's heaps of cool stuff going on with Mixie. But we still haven't looked at our second toy, which is the Beast. Time to unleash the Beast.
One eternity later.
This Beast is not easy to unleash. Finally. All right. After all that, we have our Beastlab. Instruction manual 1. Remove the printed wrap from the chamber. All right, that's this stuff. Not quite as satisfying as the Mixie. Fingerprint scanner. Right. Screw the lid. Aha, all right. Beaker, what's in here? All right, is it flashing? It is, all right. Oh, I think I know what this is. Turn to position. Oh, is it gonna explode? Okay, attack serum, all right. I think that's this stuff. Oh, it's like slime. Skin scrapings. Trying to open my packet of skin scrapings. It's just a bit of paper.
More mist.
Unleash your beast's roar with roar rocks. And lastly,
to complete the experiment, we need to put in
pandemonium crystal. All right. Okay, it's more fizzy. Oh, it's like bubbling. Oh. And then I think I have to turn the dial once more to maximum. Put the lid on. Contain the danger. Are we ready?
Oh, cool.
Oh, it's cool. So we've unleashed our shark leaf guy. He's got this like cool axe thing which he can attach to his arm. He can hit stuff.
Unleash the beast.
So both of those toys were pretty awesome. They had so many steps and there was so much to them. So I'm still not entirely sure which one is better. So it's time to tear them down to find out. Hey, we've got our speaker. There's our buddy. First thing I want to try and find is where the mist is coming from. Hey, awesome. Okay, so I'll put these guys over here. So we've worked out what creates our mist. This contraption here, which is basically a mister. So there's a liquid that is inside this container here. And as it heats up, it travels up this tube and fills the globe with fog. That liquid's actually a thing called glycerin or vegetable glycerin. I've got some vegetable glycerin here actually. I've just mixed it with a little bit of distilled water. And if we add heat, you can actually start to see it creates a lot more fog than what water would. So it's not just smoke and mirrors, it's a bit of chemistry. What I'm really interested in is how this reveal works. So how did our Mixie end up appearing inside our crystal ball? We've just worked out how the platform mechanism works, which allows Pixie to spring up from her dungeon out into the crystal ball. What we've got is a motor. That motor is connected to a whole range of these different gears here. Those gears are then attached to these kinds of spiral gears. Those spiral gears turn along with the motor and the gears. And as they turn, they essentially raise and lower the platform. I love these as well, these flaps. They're just attached on like a sort of a spring release. So as we make it go back down, they should just naturally close in. Awesome. I think, honestly, this is probably one of the coolest bits of engineering I've seen. It is hands down my favorite design for a toy. It is so clever. Very, very cool. So the Mixie gets 10 points for engineering. So how does the reveal work in the beast lab? Well, our shark is obviously too large to fit inside the base. So he's actually always just hanging outside in this chamber. Now, it does look like the chamber is completely filled with liquid, but it's not. So I've got this Barbie here in this chamber here, and it does look like the whole thing is filled with this green liquid, but it's actually just in the outside chamber. If I pull Barbie out, you can see that Barbie is nice and dry and hasn't got wet. That's very, very similar to what's happening in the beast lab. So how does the liquid drain? You'll notice that it actually happened when I pulled down this lever. And as I do that, it actually pushes up this button here, which you can see there. That button presses down on a valve underneath, which introduces air into the chamber. And as that happens, the liquid is able to drain down. I'm thinking it's going down into a secret chamber below, which is super cool. If I flip it over, a little bit comes out, but pressing the valve again, it's not filling up from the bottom, which is now the top. It's actually filling up from this bottom, which is the actual top as well. So there's a little bit of trickery going on with this, and I'm super excited to pull it apart and figure out how it works. I think this is the last bit. Aha, awesome. Sweet, we have our chamber. The liquid currently is in the compartment up the top here in the black, and you can see that gravity is allowing it to flow down into this tube. Pressing the valve again is actually allowing air out, which means that the liquid is able to flow through. That's basically just a thing called liquid displacement. And we can show that really, really easily using a straw and some liquid here. Plug up the top, no air is getting in, so no liquid can come out. But if we let air in, liquid can come out. So we've teared down both the Magic Mixie and the Beastlab. So which is the better toy? Now, they both have similarities in that they both create that mist from vegetable glycerin, and they also have a really cool reveal. What I didn't like about this is that why the magic toy was all pink and sparkly and the beast lab toy was all experiments and goo and sharks. Who decided that girls have to play with magic crystal balls and only boys get them experimenting with sharks and goo? I would have liked both, so I feel as though toy companies do better. In terms of what I preferred, I think with the Beastlab, it was a lot more hands-on and it was really cool to be able to mix stuff together. But the Mixie also has some extended play with the games and the use of the wand. I actually found it a lot more fun than I would imagine. I know me as a kid, I would have absolutely loved both of them. We are actually going to be exploring the Beastlab a little bit more next week. So tune in for our next episode where we are going to talk about all of the different experiments inside the Beastlab and how you can do them at home. And until then, it's been so much fun doing this episode today. This has been Toy Teardown. Until next time.